Pittsburgh.
You know, Fleury's ready, Stay, coming off the shutout.
He's just been absolutely incredible at home. 5 goals against in his last 5 home starts. And there's Louis, Roberto Luongo, back in a Florida Panthers uniform and helping them to get to a playoff spot. They are sitting in the playoff picture at the moment. And not surprised if you knew the acquisitions they made in the offseason. Pretty good acquisitions by their GM, Dale Talon. Their new coach is Gerard Gallant, making his first debut here in Pittsburgh as a member of the Florida Panthers.
Score! That shot eluded the glove of Luongo. Nick Spaling will take that. It's 1-0.
A knuckler. And the 35-year-old Luongo could not track it down. That's why you just got to shoot the puck. And Spaling gets that pass. There's the shot. Looked like it hit the blade of the Florida Panther out high. Right there, possibly just nicking the blade of Goodbranson. And that knuckler goes right by the right shoulder. Luongo tries to play it across his body with that glove, and he was just waving that air as that puck went off the bar and in. And a great start for the Pens.
Wow, we have an offside call on the Florida Panthers.
It's hard to tell if it hit the stick of Goodbranson or not, but it certainly was knuckling all the way in, dropped a couple of feet on Luongo, and for Spaulding, there's that long-range shot. Looked like Luongo just got a little piece of it as it went by, and would have been better off playing it with the other side of his body.
Back, it gets caught up in traffic here, and it's dumped in by the Penguins. Andrew Ebbett, Farnham, and Rust. And Farnham in on the forecheck against Ekblad. Ekblad turned it over to Rust, who handed it off to Farnham, and now out to Scuderi. Back in deep for Brian Rust. Penguins' fourth line was good the other night with Adams centering. Tonight it's Andrew Ebbett. Adams is out of the lineup. His streak comes to an end. Here's Rust shooting off a stick. Over to get it goes Andrew Ebbett. Back behind the net for Farnham.
A lot of passion here in this line. All over the place, moving their feet. Great work started with Bobby Farnham. Now with Rust.
Rust with a backhander, floating it in there, and a blocker save made again by Luongo. On a changeup by Brian Rust from 55 feet away. Now Boland working deep in his own zone. Penguins get their third line on. Downey got to the puck first. Back to Scuderi, shot. Comes right to the stick of Spaulding. Ekblad has him covered. Spaulding sends it behind the net to Downey. Steve Downey steps out of the corner. Centers down. Pouliot with a shot. He scores!
Well, does Pouliot join the ranks of Maryland Mutes, scoring his first game on his first shot? Not on his first shift. But Pouliot is so aggressive and active. That offensive defenseman, 5 in his last 7 in Wilkes-Barre. Derrick Pouliot, 8th overall, rips it over that glove hand of Luongo, who just can't find him. The width of that pass down below the circle. And for Derrick Pouliot, a goal scorer from the blue line, knows exactly where to put it in that top shelf. That is tremendous stuff, and he comes as advertised. We had over 30 points, and he's now an NHLer.
Florida Panthers on the power play. Here's Campbell with it. He shoots it off the goalpost. Harrington in the box for high sticking. The Panthers ranked 25th with a man advantage. They want to get it going. They score, too. Well, they did get it going. It was deflected in front of the net. Jonathan Huberdeau right there.
Trocheck,
and Trocheck, I think, is going to get the goal.
Yep.
Vince Trocheck deflected it in. And he comes. Pouliot gets one in his debut, and Trocheck gets one in his return to Pittsburgh.
Yeah, take a look. 21, stick on the ice. Right after a goal post, there's a hard shot, a redirection. Trocheck from Huberdeau. Just catches the bottom of the blocker over the right pad of Fleury as he's looking through traffic, and he doesn't get enough of the puck. And that power play does strike on the Harrington penalty. And, yep, the Pittsburgh native, Vincent Trocheck, makes it 2-1.
They had not scored a power play goal in their last 6 games. They were 0 for their last 14. They get one there. They get right back into this hockey game. Now Rust behind the net. Campbell just whacked him with a stick. And Ekblad takes it down for the Panthers. Somehow got the puck around. Big collision. Ekblad got crushed by Bobby Farnham. And now another chance for Ekblad to try to clear it. And now they run over Bobby Farnham. Campbell got in there to return the favor.
Well, Ekblad's checking his face right now. His chin strap around his chin and not under it. And he's cut on the bridge of his nose. And Bobby Farnham is just going to keep running and running. And
2 minutes interference.
His head actually hit the chin of Ekblad. You can see as Farnham came in to make contact, his helmet is what hits Ekblad right in the facial area. And Bobby Farnham's just going to keep coming and coming. And there you see the penalty that Campbell took on him. You can see it in his face and a little lip service to himself. One to knock it. Look out.
2 minutes to the goal. Off the goal post. Rebound Morgan. Stop. Don't know what that hit. Here's Rosecrans with it. And the double blows.
Double post.
Double post.
Double post. Kunitz post. Malkin post. The same post.
Christmas bells behind Roberto Luongo.
Incredible stuff. Looked like Malkin had the wide open cage. Just could not find the net. There was a stick in the way. Looked like Mitchell as Malkin went to try to hit the second, the rebound off the post. There's the initial one. It's going to bounce over the stick. There's the first one to the blocker side of Luongo, and the puck comes out, and you'll see the second opportunity. Mitchell may have just got a piece of it, preventing that puck from going in behind Luongo. Had no clue. And when it came back the third time, Staggy, after the whistle, the puck hit the same post again. Did you see that? There's a magnet there. And I'm not exactly sure why the officials are convening right now.
I think they might be, I don't think they're reviewing this, are they?
Well, it didn't go in. It hit the goalpost a couple of times, but did we hear a whistle after that second post? Did they blow it dead thinking that possibly it went in, Staggy? Because the puck still looked like it was free, and then there was a whistle. It wasn't frozen, was it? So it is under review. Let's take a look here, guys, one more time. So we get the Kunitz goalpost, clearly. The second one by Malkin. And then the puck wasn't frozen dead or anything, but the referees did blow it dead right now. So apparently somebody thought it may have gone in. And they don't believe there was any other reason for that whistle. You can see Hornquist saying, why did you blow the whistle? And that really prevented the Penguins from getting another crack as Luongo was floundering and had no idea where that puck was. Listen up, we'll get an explanation here.
After video review, the second shot hit the goalpost, no goal.
So apparently they had thought that the second opportunity had possibly gone in and blown it dead, and right then and there. Well, we get some more horns in the penalty box right now.
Coming out of the penalty box, Fleischman centers all the way through, taken by Kunitz. Crosby takes off, wants the puck, trying to take it around Mitchell. He's got it. Crosby to the goal. Stopped by the Luongo. And no goal. I think the puck might be in the net, but they're waving that off because the Penguins went hard to the net. But a tremendous effort by Crosby. If he had scored there, he would have brought the house down.
Yeah, there's going to be at least one penalty. And now we see, I believe, Letang mixing it up here. Punches being thrown against Letang right now. Mitchell hit him with his helmet. Referee wasn't even looking at it. Mitchell grabbed the helmet and hit Letang with the helmet. And that could be a fine suspension if the NHL looks at that. Referee had his back turned to that situation. Mitchell grabbed that helmet and banged it off the side of Letang's head. Mitchell was going after Malkin earlier, and these Florida Panthers, after their young guy Ekblad was battered by Farnham, they have really upped it up, stepped it up in the chippy department here, and are manning up against the Penguins unit. There was initial penalty called there as the Penguins went to the net. I believe it may have been against Hornquist, not exactly sure. Sidney Crosby made one heck of a play in that neutral zone and really being able to get that puck by Mitchell. as we sort things out. Take a look at this puck. It comes up and he lifts a stick of Mitchell there because he couldn't get to the puck. He stayed with it. Look at the backward, forward, going to there. And then Letang jams it. There's a hard hit on Hornquist. He should not have been penalized. I believe maybe the hit against Hornquist was penalized as Letang jammed at that puck, trying to get it over the goal line. And we'll just see how this all shakes up.
Now, it was Dylan Olsen who flattened Hornquist.
And I don't know if we have a look at what happened to Chris Letang, but there was a bunch of punches right there. There's Letang. Let's see how this finishes up. Letang's going to lose his helmet here, guys. And if we stick with it, watch Mitchell. Watch what he does. After he throws a couple of punches, grabs a helmet, and then bang! Tries to hit Letang. I don't know if he got Letang. Maybe more of the linesman arm. If you look at it right there, and the referee looking at the other pile.
And Steve Downey is talking it up right now on the bench, yelling at the Panthers from across the way.
Yeah, and they got it on the big board right now. They're loving it. Let's take one more look at the opportunity. Mitchell, there's a pile up right in front of the net. You see the referee pointing from that hit stick, I think on Olsen. Looks like Olsen the initial one. And then you see Mitchell here. Mitchell's throwing punches even though Letang is tied up by the official. There's two punches, then he grabs the helmet. I think he may have clipped Letang, more the arm of the linesman, as you can see that helmet. Andy McElman taking more of the brunt of that hit.
Branson headmans the puck, 3-on-2 for the Panthers, and a shot down low by Kopechka. Stopped by Fleury, and now Downey going at it with Gud Branson. They said they were going to get together, and they do.
Well, Branson's a big man.
And he is
pounding away. Downey's trying to take some time, and there he is. And he got it right in there on Gabranson as they went down.
Downey's not done yet.
Well, he's going to get an extra misconduct for that. As he just is relentless right now. Referees don't like that, and he's sending Downey out. They're sending Downey out.
Downey's saying, hey, you're at five. It's 6 inches taller than me.
Yeah, Gudbranson's a big man, and he was he had the sledgehammer going there for a while. But Downey waited and he waited, and they went down. And
now it is Fleury backhanding it around to the right side for Rust. Rust comes ahead with Malkin. Instead, he passes it over to Como. Como drops it off. The shot by Harrington, and a glove save made by Luongo. That's a beauty there.
Yeah.
That's a good one. He caught that one behind his body. Brought it back to life. Big save by Luongo. He's got the glove up. You see, puts it up in position early. And yeah, makes a real nice save. Luongo that time on the top of his crease to deny the slap shot of Harrington. Our Super Bowl presented by Allegheny Health Network showing that. There's Farnham. And that is his second hit. And then he came up a little bit lame there, guys. Bobby Farnham had to go to the dressing room.
He's been so good this year, that calmness that he has in the net.
Yeah, he's really looking these shots into his glove.
Yeah.
You notice that in the last two. He's just watching the puck in his head. You can see it go right into the glove with that puck.
Here's a chance now for Fleischman. A big save and another one by Fleury. And he's scrambling around, and I think he kept the puck out again on Jokinen, who may have got that puck towards the goal.
Did
Fleury,
he
maybe three saves there. I think the third one with his goal stick.
I don't know how he made the third one if he did. I don't know how he made the second one. Seriously, that's incredible stuff. I'm sitting here wondering how you can react that quickly.
He's just playing out of his mind right now.
Well, from the overhead, let's look at the work of Marc-Andre Fleury. One, two, and a third. Hello. Thank you.
Ryan Rust sends it down the wall. Back up top now for Dupre. And a cross taken by Letang. For the shot. Deflected. Sidney Crosby.
His first home goal in 11 games for Sidney Crosby. And his third in 21. A goal post on a redirect in front of Marc-Andre Fleury. The Penguins take it the other way. Great play from Dupre. Fake. And then watch Letang freeze Luongo. Luongo gets locked in. And there's the shot redirect by Sidney Crosby, Staggy. His first goal at home in 11. And the Penguins get that third one on the board, that insurance marker.
I saw Crosby do that a lot the year that he suffered his concussion when he was getting those deflection goals, getting down around the net and steering pucks in. There's a good chance again on a redirect, and Fleury kicked the puck out with his right pad. Another shot by Mitchell hit something in front.
Tremendous save by Fleury through traffic and redirect, and he's in perfect position. He just flicks that right leg out. It's just a little subtle move.
In the neutral zone was Crosby. 41 seconds to go in the game. Penguins up by two.
Fleury
wants to shoot it for the goal. He fires it that way. How about the way he pounced on that puck? That was dramatic. Oh, if only he could have done it.
I know. He's just got to do a few more wrist curls, Staggy. He's trying.
I just got to love the way he stepped up to that puck. Crosby just got decked in center. He went down pretty hard. 21 seconds to go in the game. Here's Kunitz with the empty net, and that one doesn't get there.
The stick broke when he went to shoot the puck.
He drops it now and goes to the bench. And Bergenheim dumps the puck in, an offside call on the Florida Panthers.
Oh, man. Marc-Andre Fleury, he'll try and try until he succeeds.
Watch him pounce.
There he is. Glove. Down. Shot. Yeah, Bergenheim was going to get back there anyways. They were flagging it down. And then Kunitz had a chance. Crosby was a little offside anyhow. It probably wouldn't have counted. However, the stick broke in two when he went to shoot it at the empty cage. You know, he wasn't chuckling too much at that.
46 shots. One goal for the Florida Panthers here tonight. And the Penguins with three on 34 shots. 2 seconds to go in the game. 1 second. Another sensational performance by Marc-Andre Fleury behind a lineup that featured some young guys, one of whom is standing right there, number 51, our McDonald's player of the game with his first career goal in his NHL debut, Derrick Pouliot.
Yes, a great shot up over the glove hand of Luongo. It was a game-winning goal for Derrick Pouliot, the Penguins' second goal of the game. And Marc-Andre Fleury, seriously, never ever seen him play better in his career. At 30 years of age, the flower is just blossoming again.
He absolutely is. Let's go to Robin J.